Cancer is a scary word for anyone to hear. It is one of those aspects of the medical field that has such diversity to it. There will never be a single cure because of the many types of cancer, the differences in how various tissues are affected, and the many unique causes. In this video, we will discuss how cancer develops, the factors that increase risk, and how nutrition is impacted by treatment. We look at cancer on a continuum. How we approach prevention and early detection through screening is very different than how we approach treatment and recovery after diagnosis. Nutrition plays a critical role both in prevention and in treatment. Cancer begins with the initiation of a carcinogen or other type of factor entering cells and altering the DNA. The now modified DNA will produce mutated daughter cells. The changes that occur to the DNA can also affect the cell's ability to stop production of new cells, causing mutated cells to grow rapidly. This promotion of cell replication results in development of a tumor or accumulation in blood, lymph, or tissue. Eventually, it can spread to other tissue known as metastasis. At each stage, there are external influences that can prevent or increase the process. Much of the initial stage in cancerous cells forming is due to genetic factors. A genetic defect may allow DNA in specific type of cells to be more susceptible to alterations that make them cancerous. Environmental factors are normally coupled with genetics. For example, a person with defective DNA may come in contact with a carcinogen from the environment, such as asbestos, radiation, smoking, or a bacteria like H. pylori. Immune factors affect both stages of carcinogenesis. Processes of the immune system may produce oxidants that cause DNA damage in the initial stages. Chronic inflammation is known to increase promotion or cellular division of cells, speeding up the process. Dietary factors also affect initiation and promotion stages of cancer development. But with diet, there are good and bad aspects for both stages. In the initial stage, we know that foods contain carcinogens that may induce cellular mutations. The carcinogens in food are largely affected by cooking methods at very high temperatures like frying and with smoke like grilling. However, it is not believed that carcinogens alone cause cancer. It is also likely coupled with a genetic predisposition to cellular mutation. On the other hand, we have components in food that prevent cells from being transformed, such as antioxidants and phytochemicals, or that help repair damaged cells, like the B vitamins, or prevent proliferation of cells, like fiber. The bottom line is that cancer is very complex and involves multiple aspects in terms of prevention. Knowing these risk factors and obtaining cancer screenings can help with early detection so that if a person develops cancer, we will have a better chance of recovery. Once diagnosed with cancer and treatment begins, the complications will depend on location of the cancer, the stage of it, and treatment utilized. In order for the body to reach a stage of recovery, adequate nutrients for repair of damaged cells and growth of healthy ones will be necessary. So when treatment or severity interferes with adequate nutrition, it presents a huge problem. Treatment plans will often include combinations of medication known as chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery. Unfortunately, the treatment has complications for nutrition. For example, chemotherapy can cause nausea, vomiting, and changes to food taste that interfere with adequate intake, leading to anorexia. Radiation can interfere with body processes that affect nutrition, such as radiation to the neck that may cause dysphagia or to the colon that leads to constipation or diarrhea. One of the worst complications in cancer is cachexia. This is a form of anorexia that is characterized by increased metabolism, decreased appetite, weight loss, muscle wasting, anemia, fatigue, and psychological stress. The condition occurs in up to 50% of cancer cases. Without adequate nutrition from decreased appetite and loss of lean tissue, the body will not be able to recover. It often spirals down to slow deterioration towards death. With the physiological and psychological changes caused by cancer, it takes more than nutrition intervention or willpower to reverse cachexia. Nutrition plays a large role in cancer prevention and treatment. As you are considering the effects of cancer, use your resources from the course to identify the best strategies to prevent cancer from developing. Then think about how to improve nutrition once a person has cancer and experiences consequences like nausea, early satiety, dry mouth, foods not tasting right, dysphagia, and diarrhea.